يا من عصيت الله يوما غافلا فنسيت أن الله قد أعطى
وأشهد أن محمد العظم ورسوله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The respected brothers and sisters, the topic in this khutbah inshallah will be about the significance on the last months, how we learn from Ramadan. What's the lessons that we learn from last Ramadan? And I would like to start that is the most significant act of Ramadan after fasting is that maybe each and every one of us notice that a big number of people will come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to attend the obligatory prayer. But what is next after Ramadan? What is next after Ramadan? In Ramadan, we have that good bond, we have that good attachment to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is the obligatory prayer regarding Taraweeh. But how to maintain that attachment in Ramadan, after Ramadan? We need to remember the importance of the obligatory prayer. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in hadith, أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ خَيْرَ أَمَلَكُمْ صَلَاهُ مَيْ أُمَّةِ. Be aware that prayer is your best action. Is your best action. There is no action that more superior than the prayer. Therefore, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, مَنْ حَفِظَهَا وَحَافَظَ عَلَيْهَا حَفَظَ دِينَ. Whoever guards his prayer, he will guard the other aspect of his deen. And whoever disregards his prayer, he will disregard the other aspect of his deen. What does that mean? Means that prayer is a shield of protection to you from indulging in doing wrong. And that is the meaning. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ. That prayer is a shield of protection to you from doing wrong. Prayer is a shield of prayer automatically has the power. By nature, whenever you do your prayer, according to the manners of Islam, by nature is a shield of protecting you in doing wrong. That is the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ. That prayer is your shield of protection from doing wrong. What's the best manner of prayer? The best manner of prayer is, number one, do it in time. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَّوْقُوتًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, prayer have an appointed time. It have an appointed time. Don't combine up Salat al-Zuhur with Salat al-Asr, or Salat al-Asr with Salat al-Maghrib without al-Riyyah al-Thalib. Please. So number one is do it in time. Number two is do it with a presence in your heart. Have a concentration in your heart. Have a devotion in your heart. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نَظْرُهُمْ بِصَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, successful indeed those who are having presence in their heart while they are in prayer. Meaning that have concentration. While in prayer, don't think that way and that way and that way. Present your heart. Have that good concentration. Because this is, whenever as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, يُكْتَبْ لَهُمَا عَقَلِ مِنْهَا. That your prayer, the standard of your prayer, the grade of your prayer, will be affected by the presence of your heart. So number two is, have concentration while you are in prayer. Number three is, do it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seek the way to do it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, Salat al-Jama'at al-Qudu Salat al-Fardhi 27 layla. The congregation prayer is 27 times more superior in the world than the individual prayer. What we said is seek the way to beauty is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be serious and practical to do that. Just have a simple example to this. If someone over there have done his prayer at home 5 times a day, let's say it's Saturday or Sunday, or he is one of those are pensioners, he have done it at home 5 times a day, he will get 5 full grade. If someone over there, he have done it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it will be 5 times 27, which is 175 grade. So that means the one who have done it at home, he will get 5 full grade. The one who have done it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get 175 grade in one day. In one day. What about 1 week? What about 1 week? What about 1 month? What about 1 year? What about all your life? Such a big, big difference. Such a big difference. What's the importance of this? The importance of this, you pray because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَإِشْرَةُ اللَّهِ. Whoever have a heart and heavy scale of the day of judgment will be having salvation, will be having security and safety on the day of judgment. And whoever have that light great, that light gives, will be not having that salvation, not having that safety. That's the important. Therefore, the best manner to in Islam to do your prayers, do it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do it in time, do it while presenting your heart. Have that consideration while doing prayer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, As-salatu ibadatin. Your prayer is the pillar of the deen. Your pillar of deen. And it is your question number one for the day of judgment. Awwal ma yuhasabu bihi Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Awwal ma yuhasabu bihi wa salat. Question number one is the day of judgment about your prayer. So that is the excellence. Do your prayer in Ramadan. One of the lessons that, yes, we come in a big number to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But after Ramadan, having that intention and be practical, I want to keep the bond between me and between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer. And always remember, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most beloved land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a man came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to him, Ya Rasulullah, ma ahabu bilalullahi to Allah. O Prophet, what is the most beloved land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the earth? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, al-masajidu ahabu bilalullahi to Allah. That is the most beloved land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the earth. The most beloved land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the earth. Therefore, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he names the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, al-masajidu biyutillah. Al-masajidu biyutillah, the most is the house of Allah. Therefore, whenever you go to pray in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor you by multiplication in the grade of your prayer, that will be 27 times more supreme. 27 times more supreme. Therefore, please have that attachment with the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek the way you want to do the house, you want to do your prayer in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's about the obligatory prayer. And then what is the lesson of Tarawih? The lesson we get from Taraweeh is, yes, Taraweeh is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After Ramadan, we don't have Taraweeh. But what is that you can act upon? So many you can act upon it, like Qiyamul Layl. Qiyamul Layl, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمِنَ الْلَيْلِ لِتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَ الْلَيْلَ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. He named Qiyamul Layl, O Prophet. Do as best as you could in Qiyamul Layl, obligatory upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for us as a Muslim, Qiyamul Layl is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, Afdalus Salat, Afdalus Salat ba'da al-Fariḍa Qiyamul Layl. That means the best prayer after the obligatory prayer is Qiyamul Layl. It's the best prayer after the obligatory prayer. It means the best is in that, in reward. And it is the honor of the day of judgment. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, the angel Jibreel said to me, Qiyamul Layl sharaf al-mu'min. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the angel Jibreel said to him, Qiyamul Layl tahajjud is, it is the honor of the believer on the day of judgment. On the day of judgment, either we will be honored or we will be dishonored. There is nowhere in between. Therefore, Qiyamul Layl is an honor to us on the Day of Judgment. And then, therefore, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, even in Qiyamul Layl, if you offer only two rak'ah, only two rak'ah, you will be written with those al-dhakirin, Allah al-dhakirin wa al-dhakirat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you do Qiyamul Layl and offer only two rak'ah, every two rak'ah, what you want your third or fourth rak'ah, you will be written with the category, those are the number Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the importance of you being written with those are the number Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The importance of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتَ عَبْدَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. If you written with those are, if you be with those are the number Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, those are the people of forgiveness on the Day of Judgment. Remember, imagine if you come on the Day of Judgment for accountability. Everyone will become for accountability. And if you find that, your name is the people whom is being forgiven. Be forgiven. Why be forgiven? Because you do Qiyamul Layl. Therefore, please do your best. So as after Ramadan, one of the lessons that we learned from Taraweeh is do Qiyamul Layl. And the good practice, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Khayru Aada. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, the goodness is habit. It's habit. Whatever you have to do yourself, you find it's very easy. It's not difficult. It's very easy. How to have to do yourself? Initially, you may find it very difficult to do Qiyamul Layl. But after that, it will be good for you and easy. And what is Qiyamul Layl? After someone said, for example, he missed Qiyamul Layl for one reason, or haven't been able to do Qiyamul Layl, then to you, it's a day. There is a man, many times you can do, inshallah, the nafil after the sunnah, you can do as much as nafil. Like, for example, was the sunnah even of Prophet Muhammad, like Salat al-Duha. سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها في بداية الشتاء كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي الضحى أربعا ويزيد ما يشاء. السيدة عائشة في بداية ذلك النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to pray صلاة الضحى for ركعة and he add as much as he could. صلاة الضحى هي سنة النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the time of صلاة الضحى is 15 minutes after the sunrise up to 15 minutes before the timing, the appointed time of Salat al-Zuhr. That is Salat al-Duha. So it's one of the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Try to practice this. MashaAllah, we have a good time. Do it, alhamdulillah, and go ahead with it. In addition to that, at any time between Zuhr and Asr, for example, you can pray as much as you would after Sunnah. It's not forbidden. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man came to him and said to him, Ya Rasulullah, أرأيت إن صليت بين الظهر والعصر. أو Prophet, if I pray between الظهر والعصر, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, you have, I said, أنت مصلي, you are praying. It's a prayer. So if someone is feel potential, if someone is feel fresh and energetic, he wants to do more after the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, so do as much as you could. Do as much as you could. Rabi'a is one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said to him, he used to serve Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to serve Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, send me ya Rabi'a. Oh Rabi'a, ask me whatever you wish. Rabi'a, he said to him, I need your company in paradise. I need your company in paradise. Imagine. This Rabi'a, when he said that, is only 14 years old. 14 years old. He used to serve Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as appreciation, out of acknowledgement to his service, he said to him, ask me whatever you wish. Imagine someone who is 14 years old. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, if you ask anyone at this age, he will need wish something in dunya. But this is the way of the Prophet Muhammad. Also, he's 14 years old, he said to Prophet Muhammad, he asked him something about Akhirah. He said to him, Murafaqatak fi jannah, I need your company for Allah. So what is that? What is the answer of Prophet Muhammad? He said, A'inni ala dhalika bikathr al-sujood. A'inni ala dhalika ya Rabi'a bikathr al-sujood. Oh Rabi'a, do sujood as much as you could. Do sujood as much as you could. Even like Tawbah, So when came Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, also one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he came to him and said to him, Ya Rasulullah, direct me to an action more brought to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Direct me to an action more brought to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, Alayka al-misr al-sijun. فَإِنَّكَ مَا سَجِدْتَ سَجْدَةً إِلَّا رَفَعَكَ اللَّهُ بِهَا دَرَجَةً يُقَطِّبُكَ عَنْهَا خَطِيئَةً. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, do sujood, prostrate to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala as much as you could. In every each single sujood, in every each single prostration, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will rank you up to higher rank and wash out one of your wrongdoings. They put this for us. Between Zuhr and Asr, Salat al-Duha, Qiyam al-Layl, as much as you could, do as much as you could. Do as much as you could. And what of this optional prayer? What of this optional prayer that we learn from Taraweeh? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once said to me one of the sound hadith that been related in Musnad al-Imam ibn Ahmad. He said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment, whenever there is a shortcoming and deficiency in your obligatory prayer, in your obligatory prayer, if there is shortcoming, if there are any deficiency and weaknesses, Allah will say to the angel, أَنْظُرُوا لِعَبْدِهَا لَوْ مِنْ نَافِلَةً. Look on the record of my servant. Has he offered any optional prayer? Then they will take from the optional prayer to adjust the weaknesses in your obligatory prayer. In your obligatory prayer. Security. أقول ربي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم أستغفر الله لكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. We are talking with respect to the lessons that we take from Ramadan, from Taraweeh and from the obligatory prayer. And we are saying that please try to do your best so as to keep the home with the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you could. And alhamdulillah, if someone say, okay, according to my own circumstances, I will not be able to go to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as I could, what should I do? Then, at that point, you need, alhamdulillah, inshallah, if you've been compared by circumstances around you, you haven't been able to come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you should be, then, at home, do a congregation prayer with your family. Why? Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in hadith, صَلَاطُ الرَّجُلُ مَعَ الرَّجُلُ خَيْرٌ لَهُمْ بِصَلَاطُ الرَّحِيمِ وصلاة الرجل مع الرجل لا خير له من صلاة مع الرجل وما زاد أحق إلى الله. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said in hadith, when a man pray with another man is better to him than pray alone. And when he pray with two is better to him than pray with one. And more than that is more beloved to Allah. Is more beloved to Allah. Therefore, if you being forced by circumstances that you haven't been able to come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at home, with your guest, with your cousin, with your mom, with your dad, inshallah, you have a congregation prayer at home. Have that congregation prayer at home. Also, along with that, one of the lessons that we get from Ramadan, from Quran, the lesson we get from Ramadan, from Quran, maybe each and every one of us increase the portion of the recitation of Quran in Ramadan. What about the relationship after Ramadan with Quran? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he had a lovely statement. He said, "Man ahabba Allah ahabba kalamah." If you love Allah, you love His speech. Quran is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the way of the companion Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to recite Quran on a regular basis because that's the teaching which is being given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Abdullah ibn Umar. When Abdullah ibn Umar asked him questions about how to recite Quran, then he recited Quran on a regular basis. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, حَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَّهِ أَدُومَهَا وَيَنْقَلَّ. That the most beloved action to Allah is that which you do it in a regular basis, even if it's a little. To do it in a regular basis, that's fine. Alhamdulillah. But the right to recite Quran not randomly. Not here today and then after 2 days here or maybe. No. You start reciting Quran from the beginning, heading for the khatma. And know when you will do the khatma. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in hadith, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالُ لِلَّهِ الْحِلُّ وَالْرِحْلَةِ. The most beloved action to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start the Quran from the beginning and do it khatma. And that's the way of the companion Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to ask among themselves, when will be your khatma? والنبي خدمة والنبي خدمة so as to attend that because they believe that on the خدمة of Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we send down the peace we send down the peace the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be sent down I will give them the victory why? Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith in Allah who yasra fi hadha al-Quran arwam wa yadha khareem Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said with Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will liberate and give victory to some people who are this way and put down others this way meaning that if you recite Quran on a regular basis if you act according to the Quran Allah will give us the victory we'll give you the victory and if you disregard the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put down you this way victory of what? Victory may be above your own family problem your own sickness whatever the problem that you get through whatever the affliction that you get through the suffering that you get through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you victory due to recitation of Quran Once there is a man called Usayd ibn Nadir. Usayd ibn Nadir is one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And once while he was reciting Quran, he had seen a cloud come down and down to him with the light in it. With the light in it. And then he gets scared. And he went and addressed this to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said to him, oh Prophet, while I was reciting Quran, I have seen cloud come down and down to me. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, هذه السكينة تنزل في القرآن. Oh my brother, this is the peace Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it down due to recitation of Quran. This is the peace Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it down because of recitation of Quran. We need to ask ourselves, after Ramadan, are you still reciting Quran on a regular basis? Are you still doing that? Your wife is still doing that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless those who are saying to you, put a good example to their family. Recite the Quran in early morning, or at least during the day, before sleeping. This is the way of the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless the people who said to their children, don't go to school. My daughter, my son, don't go to school unless you recite the Quran in early morning and then go to school. The companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even at the time of war, even at the time in the battlefield, they used to recite Quran, like Surah Al-Anfal. Why? They believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory because of the recitation of Quran. Because of the recitation of Quran. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, at the time of the battlefield, whenever he come to the camp and find some people recite the Quran and do Qiyam al-Layl, he used to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from here the victory will come. From here the victory will come. And when he finds the other company sleeping, he said the defeat will come from here. That's the recitation of Quran. If you love Allah, lead your speech. Love his speech. Don't disregard the Quran. This one of the great reasons that we learn it from Quran. So please, don't disregard the Quran. And we need to bring our action to an account. Since Ramadan, up to now, 5 weeks, 6 weeks, how many times do you recite the Quran? How many times do you recite the Quran? Quran is a peace. Is shifa to you. From that you have it, and from that you don't know. There is no shifa. As Imam Ibn Qayyim said in one of his books, that Quran is the most significant shifa for any disease. There is no shifa. There is no remedy. It's more superior than Quran. From that which you know, and from that which you don't know. Once in one of the mosques, after finishing the obligatory prayer, I noticed that there is a British man, he just beside me. I said to him, brother, I'm very happy to see a man like you as a Muslim here in the house of Allah. And the brother said to me, no, I'm not a Muslim. I said to him, brother, I'm not a Muslim. But why are you doing the house of Allah? And he said to me, peace. I said to him, peace. Do you mean that you join us because you want peace? Do you feel peace here? He said, yes. Whenever I listen to you, I feel peace. I feel peace. That's a peace. Yes, it's a peace. That's why I said to you that Usayd ibn Nadir, one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he has seen the cloud and addressed it to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, that is a peace he sent down because of the recitation of the Quran. That is a peace he was sent down. And subhanAllah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَانْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ Upon the recitation of the Quran, upon the recitation of the Quran, listen to the Quran, and keep quiet. Allah will show mercy one. Allah will show mercy one. have a sign from over there to over the speech. Is that Allah khair? Allah ma dina fi hadi. Afina fi man afi. Tawalla fi man tawalla. Mubarak lana fi ma ati. Wa qina sharri ma ati. Fa idha qadarti wa la yadh alay. Innahu la yazid man walay. Tabarak rabbana wa ta'ala. Allah mahsin lana min khashyatik ma tahul bihi baynana wa ma'siyatik. Allah mahsin lana min khashyatik ma tahul bihi baynana wa bayna ma'siyatik. Wa min ta'atik ma tubliqni bihi jannatik. Wa min al-yaqin ma tahun bihi alayna masa'ib ad-dunya. Wa ta'ala bi asma'ina wa absarina wa quwwatina ma ahtana wa ja'alhu al-waris minna. Wa ja'al thalana 'ala man dhalamana. Wa sunna 'ala man 'adana. Wa la ta'al مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا اكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين وانصر الاسلام والمسلمين وايد الاسلام والمسلمين. Anyone have any concern, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take it away from him. Those are sick, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them shifa. Those are passed away, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show mercy on them. قوموا الى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.